what could it be? MZ71 something or other, Made in Mexico jazz bass. Looks pretty spanky. Set up like ass. We're figuring this is new to the individual that owns it, so we're gonna look inside. We think there's been some upgrades. We just want to make sure that it's not. Hey, I'm just filming, and now they like me. I'll be back in a second. Well, that was cool. That was my good buddy Scully, guitar technician, stage tech extraordinaire. Worked with Geddy Lee for nearly 20 years and just finished working with Jeff Beck. So, you know, if you have questions, I have answers. With that being said, if there's a naysayer out there that figures I don't know what I'm doing, well, you can take it up with Scully.
Okay, so once again, we're at that pivotal moment where we want to look at how straight the neck is, and I can just see it with my eye. It's approaching Chiquita. Reckon velocity. Yeah. So, let's just loosen the strings off. Let's see if the truss rod actually works the way it should. Once again, the problem with most of the stuff that I see is that it's never had any incremental adjustments over time. So what happens at that point is the neck was probably set the way it should, then it got a little more curved due to weather or the wood, or we don't know. That's why they make a truss rod. But then nobody dealt with it. So a year goes by and then it curves a little more, and another year goes by and it curves a little more. And you get into the situation where the truss rod really has a hard time overcoming what's going on. So let's just see. It loosens, but it seemed to be pretty tight already. So we'll just give it a crank and get the straight edge out and see what happens. The string tension's off. So hopefully if I can make the neck straight without string tension. See, and I actually think I put it in a back bow, which is good. That's a good thing. It tells me that it works the way it's supposed to work. We're just going to release it a bit. And because we're starting over, we're going with flats. These are rounds, so nothing that's set now makes any matter. So just make sure we can get the neck straight. Wow. Okay. I didn't really think the truss rod would be that responsive, but obviously it is. Without the strings on it. Okay, it's a little humpy around the between the third and the fifth fret. Let's just get the shit off it and have a better look.
So once again, I'm here at my straight edge. And it gets humpy. Now I do it from this side. You can see it come through like a snake. Gap, gap, hump. Humpy, humpy. Gap, 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 gap. So we've got a rise right in here. I don't know, loosen it off again. See if that hump comes out. The problem is when we get string tension on it, see, we gotta go down this end here where you can see. See, we touch there and then we get a gap and a gap and a gap and a gap. A gap and a gap and a gap and a gap and a real big gap. Gap, gap, gap. Gap, gap, gap. But now we catch here and we catch there and we catch here. I'll get it from this side. Right? So, yank. I hate to break the news to you, but in order for this to work right, it probably needs some fret leveling. Alright? Because we got a hump at this end. And we got a hump down here at this end. Yank. Well, it's going to be a little more to set up. Okay, we'll do this a different way. This is sitting on top of all the frets. Same 4 thou feeler gauge. Passes through here. Right, passes through there. Now we're tight. Tight, 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 tight. Tight, tight. Now it'll start to pass through again. Alright. So I'm going to just release the truss rod a little bit more. See if that hump wants to come out of it. Big gap, big gap, big gap. Tight, 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 tight. And now see, now we got relief there. And now it's going to get tight up at the end. Interesting. Yeah. If it wasn't for this one, that's low. These are high. I wish I was high. Yeah, screw this. It's like fret leveling. Anyhow, the call has been made. And like I said, know what I know. I could put this beautiful brand new set of strings on it. Adjust everything exactly the way it should be adjusted, and it's either going to play like ass, or there's going to be fret buzz, or there's going to be both. Anyhow, I was asked to look inside and see what the hell is going on in here. You're here with me. Could be surprised at the freaking solder monster. But no. It looks nice. They just changed the pickup. So we've got some electrical tape around the split coils that make them noiseless, I guess. Or if you wanted to split the coils. No, it looks okay. Nothing loose. Just somebody's shitty attempt at soldering. soldering. Put that back together. I really didn't plug it in. Maybe I will. It hums like a jazz bass. What the fuck? Just because it's not buttoned up. Sure.
It has been announced and decided that the frets need to be leveled, so I have made the wood as straight as possible. There's a bit of a rise here, and there's a bit of a dip here, but now we will make the frets perfectly level. We have a wonderful bunch of flat frets. Let's put the blue on them again and put the crowns back on them. It didn't take much, but it would never have played right. It would have fretted out way up here, and it wouldn't have been right. It's going to be great now. Okay, we're rocking and rolling. We got that thin blue line, which is the crowns. Now all we have to do is polish the living crap out of them. Get rid of all the scratchy marks. Okay, so here we are. Leveled, crowned, and we're starting to polish. Somebody wanted me to talk about it. I mean, I used sandpaper for a long, long time, and now I have shifted gears over to these guys. Because as I've come to realize, they're much more friendly on my old, split, tired, calloused hands. Then I found this thing, which I'm going to try right now. Because I'm at the 320 grit stage. Here. This looks pretty cool. Let's check it out. Turn your headphones down. What I usually like to do at this stage is 320 grit with this rubber flappy thing, right? But I'm thinking I can just... Wow. That works pretty good. And it sits across all the frets. And I'm pretty sure you can wash this. But you see how it works, right? You see the sponge is inside and this stuff's all coated on the outside. So I guess eventually this will wear off. But... Okay, that's that. Next question, why the different color tape, Dave? That's the way they gave it to me. In the movies, tape is black. That's why you never see it. You couldn't make a movie without tape. Tape holds everything together. So let's move on, and we're gonna go at it like with one of these guys. And they give you two of these. And these two are also washable. Of course, you gotta always wreck the packaging, Dave, to get it out. I'm gonna call this one fine. And, basically. Have at it. Go through all the grits, and I will finish with sandpaper. It will be 2,000 grit sandpaper, and then a little bit of metal polish. So let me get this done. I'll get the base back together. Put those brand new flat wound strings on it. I can't wait.
Well, it's tuned up all bitch like. What is going on with the neck straightness? I may have straightened it too much. Yes, I did. I did a little preemptive strike there before I actually tuned it to pitch, knowing that I would have to, but it's good that I just need to back it off a little bit now.
after we'll get that right for starters. Just a friendly warning to everyone. Furnace season has arrived, which means I need to prime my humidifiers and get that in order. This is usually where a lot of people bring me their guitars, right around this time of year. The furnace is going to kick in and suck the moisture out of the entire house. That's a beautiful thing there. We'll stop there for now. String height was absolutely atrocious. Let me set that.
Okay, string height set. I'm going to do the pickup height before I do the intonation, because I can tell the pickups are too close. And this is where we find out that whoever retroed the pickups put, you know, toilet paper underneath them, cardboard. I'm getting there. I think it's moving. Yeah, it's moving. There, we're there. That one's not as bad, but it's still too close. What are these pickups? I don't know. They say DiMarzio something on them. Did they seem noiseless? No, they're not very... Well... No. And now... Four. Well, that's sort of everything. A jazz bass with flat wounds, it just makes me want to play Led Zeppelin. Nice. Yeah, this thing plays great. I don't know what the price point is on this. What's MZ7? Is that 2007? Is this like 11 years old? Okay guys, thanks for hanging out. Made in Mexico, jazz bass setup, fret leveling adventure. That's what I have today. I just want to check something one more time before I say goodbye. All the information about patrons and stickers and all that stuff, it's all below in the description, guys. Special thanks to all my patrons and subscribers. And a big hoot to the Facebook group people. And cheers, folks. Be good to each other.